Hearty welcome to Alan's Tutorials, your English literature class for the students of 9 and 10, based on the ICIC pattern for the immediate preparation of your board and other exams. Class is taken by Jose Joseph Little Flower School, Salempur. Hearts and Hands. This beautiful short story is written by O. Henry. Of course, O. Henry's other stories also you must have already read. He is so popular writer. He was born in the year 1862 and died in 1910. You can look at the beautiful portrait of our O. Henry here. Let us understand, who was he? One of the most popular American short story writer. He was born on September 11 in North Carolina, U.S. His real name is William Sidney Porter. He received his education in his own school. He began his career as a humorous weekly writer, The Rolling Stone. For embezzling money, he was imprisoned. Changed his name to O. Henry to shield his identity. He was died on June 5, 1910 in New York. Introduction of this story, Heart and Hands, you can find here. It is a gripping story by O. Henry. It is a story which balance between reality and fantasy. The images the author has created in his narration have contributed to the surprise ending, which is a special trait of O. Henry. Each author has his own way of presenting the story, and in the writing of our O. Henry, the surprise twist at the end, that is what we find in his writings. And in this story, Hearts and Hands, of course, we will find the same. The characters present in this story are Miss Fairchild, Mr. Easton, the Marshal, the glum-faced man. See, all are there. The setting of this story, it is set in a train, B&M Express, Denver Station. The place is Denver Station. The story depicts casual and amusing atmosphere. It's a quite natural way some story is developed. That is what we are going to see. Plot development, how the plot of the story is developed. Miss Fairchild meets an old acquaintance, Mr. Easton, on a train. Mr. Easton's hand is handcuffed to another man. Miss Fairchild recognizes Mr. Easton. The man with whose hand Mr. Easton's hand is handcuffed says that Mr. Easton is a marshal and himself is a convict. The two men take leave from Miss Fairchild to go to the smoker car. Two passengers seated nearby reveal the identity of Mr. Easton and the other man. Let us understand the summary of this beautiful short story. The story, Hearts and Hands, is set on a train eastbound B&M Express, where an elegantly dressed, luxurious, pretty young woman, Miss Fairchild, meets by chance one of her old acquaintances, Mr. Easton. Mr. Easton greets her with his left hand, as his right hand is handcuffed with the left hand of another glum-faced, heavily built and roughly dressed man seated next to him. Miss Fairchild is surprised to see that they are handcuffed. Sensing Mr. Easton's embarrassment, The second man comes to the rescue by explaining that Mr. Easton is a marshal who is taking him to Leavenworth prison as he has got 7 years of jail term for counterfeiting, that is, cheating with money. This gives Miss Fairchild some relief and she started to think something bad about her old friend. Then they continue the conversation further. Fairchild comes to know that Mr. Easton has given up his luxurious life in Washington and has taken the job of a marshal in the West. Then the woman says she also loves the West and wants to live there. At that point, the second man demands that he must be taken to the smoker now as he hasn't had a smoke all day. So Mr. Easton races and leaves with that man, bidding goodbye to the woman. Two other passengers in a nearby seat heard the entire conversation. One of them comments that the man, Mr. Easton, holds such a prestigious post of a marshal at a very young age. Then the other man comments that he has never seen an officer to handcuff a prisoner to his right hand. So, at the very end of the story, we come to know that actually the glum-faced man is the officer and Mr. Easton is the prisoner. So what a surprise way of ending the story. Only at the last line, we come to know that who is the real marshal and who is the real criminal. Yes. What are the themes that we get from this beautiful story? Appearances can be deceptive and compassion. All that glitters are not gold. Of course, you have learned in your Merchant of Venice. Yes, same way. All the things. Easton was looking very handsome like Marshall, but in fact, he was the criminal and the glum, the ugly looking person, he was the real Marshall. And he was taking him to Leavenworth prison. And of course, from the side of our Miss Fairchild, she shows so much kindness, compassion to her old acquaintance, Mr. Easton. Thus, these are the two themes there you have to focus. Again, let us focus a little bit about the title of the story. This title is aptly titled. Plot is related to the theme, not judging people based on their outer appearance. So of course, we have heard the famous saying, never judge a book by its cover. The title part hand is related to the handcuffing, which reveals the real identity. The title heart part explains the theme of the story. So these things you have to understand. Once again, the title part hand is related to the handcuffing, which reveals the real identity, and the heart part explains the theme of the story. Then Marshall was compassionate as he did not want to embarrass both Miss Fairchild and Mr. Easton. The author has titled the story Hearts and Hands because by having the Marshall life about his hand, being that of a convict, the Marshall show his heart for the convict and highlight the theme of compassion. Thus, title is very much appropriate. The person, the real Marshall, had a good heart, and because of that heart, he showed compassion to Mr. Easton. Otherwise, who would have been in big dilemma or trouble? A critical appreciation of this beautiful story, that is, story ends with an unexpected manner, shows how a convict is saved from an embarrassing situation.